Tinkerbell, lay down. Just pacing around back there. Then she was licking the pillow.
Well, that's part of her charm. That's what
you
she does.
Dummy. Hi, everyone.
Hello.
It's been a while since we actually made a video.
Yeah.
It's been
a couple weeks.
A couple weeks at this point. So, and we have gotten packages. We actually got a number of packages. It just happened to coincide with Isabel's birthday. Yep. So we had to do some sorting through and find out whose packages were whose.
And what was what.
I did a little cheating and probably opened up all of the packages to see what they are, but I didn't show you anything.
No, I haven't seen anything. So,
but before we do that, how many weeks are you now?
29 weeks.
29.
Yep, so 11 weeks to go.
I mean, by my estimate, it's only 9 weeks to go.
Yeah. 11 mm-hmm. weeks, yeah.
So, and then we had the
ultrasound.
The ultrasound this week.
This week on the 1st, yep. Everything went great. The baby looks great. It's about 3 pounds, which is a little bigger than it should be, but we already knew that. The only thing was that the baby was being super shy and had like its hands up in its face. So we couldn't see the face. So they want me to come back. When I go back in for my regular next checkup, I have to have another one just so they can look at the features again, make sure everything's fine. They
need to make sure it's a baby and not a raccoon.
Yeah.
Exactly. They didn't see the full face. So they're not sure if it's a baby or if it's like a lasagna monster that might
be. What it looked like anyway, yeah.
Yeah.
No, but we thought, I mean, you could see it's like, you could see the baby's eyes and the nose and like half of its mouth, but it was like really just smushed into its hands.
Mm-hmm.
So it's
mm-hmm.
just being stubborn, which is not surprising knowing our children. So.
Yep. So what do you have left to do? Like you're still going every 2 weeks, right?
I'm going every 2 weeks until 35 weeks. So, and then I will go every week. And then after that, they'll probably do, because I am over 35, I have other stuff I have to do. Like they may do like a non-stress test, or they may do other stuff like that. But pretty much it's just all routine now. I just go in and they measure me and, you know, weigh me. And then they tell me like, okay, everything's good. You know, I just started monitoring the kicks now. So, mm-hmm. but I was pretty much doing that anyway. But the baby, because the baby moves all the time, so it's kind of easy.
So, in bigger news this week, other than the ultrasound, I got a snazzy new haircut.
You got a trendy do.
Uh huh.
Isabel says you got mm-hmm. a trendy haircut.
Yeah, I needed to be in preparation for when the baby comes, so that they know like Dad wasn't this hairy slob, which is what I looked like beforehand. So,
I thought you were getting in preparation because you're going to do so much when the baby comes. You weren't going to have time to maintain your do.
No. I'm trying to impress the baby. Oh, okay. That's what I'm trying to do.
Yeah, they'll remember that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Yeah. They'll remember.
Yeah, definitely.
They'll remember. So, we did get a package. Another bag.
Yes.
It's actually
two bags.
What do you think it is?
I have no idea. You won't give me any hints, so.
No. And in fact, this is the end of this video. You will not be looking at these presents.
No, I'm going to look at them anyway.
So, whoa.
You're losing yourself there.
Here you go. That's who it's from.
Oh, it's from Nicole and Rick. They're our friends in Washington.
Yeah, really good friends in Washington when we met while we were living up in Olympia.
Mm-hmm. They're super sweet.
Yeah.
And well, I thank you
guys.
For them.
Totally unexpected. Didn't think you guys would send us something. So, here you go.
Oh, it's the swaddler blankets. See? Makes it super easy. There's instructions on the back, cheek show. I'm super excited. Both our kids were not swaddle babies, but I figure we should probably have these in the house just in case this baby decides it needs to. Our kids were both like wanted to get out of blankets, and if you try mm-hmm. to swaddle them, they scream, but mm-hmm. I figured that we should have them in the house, and I don't really know how to swaddle because I didn't have to do it with the other kids. So.
Sometimes babies need to be wrapped up really tight because they get out of control.
Yeah.
Particularly our babies are maniacs, so we need to hold them down while we can.
Yeah. So it's and it's super cute. It has like the little monkey print.
So yeah, this is our theme, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yep. Jungle and jungle.
Why do you need to wrap up babies like burritos? Like,
because it comes from when they're inside your stomach, there's no space in there, right?
Uh-huh.
So they're super, like the baby, when we saw the baby in the ultrasound, the baby's knees are up here and the leg, you know, the hands are all tight. So it makes them feel more comfortable, like they're still in your stomach, mm-hmm. like when they come out. It's, I think it's really only for babies like to 3 months. Yeah. But our kids were like, Isabel was like, when she got out, was like, and we tried to wrap her up and she would scream and get her arm out. And no.
So, and then you wanted the ones that were like pre-made, right? Because mm-hmm. you're not the swaddling
expert.
I'm not
the swaddling expert. And they say now that you shouldn't put blankets in with your baby. It's like a SIDS hazard. So I would just be safer to have that, you know, gotcha. Sleep sack or that kind of style. That way they mm-hmm. can't get out and they can't roll, you know, can't roll around in it. So,
mm-hmm.
yep, I'm excited though.
Here's the other.
Oh, it's a blanket to go with our theme. And this is so soft. I saw it at the store, and I was like, I can't feel how soft it is.
And I've seen softer.
No, it's really soft.
Yeah, it's really nice. It is really soft. It's really light, too. Like, yeah, that's what's weird.
Yeah,
we need
light blankets here. Obviously, it doesn't get really warm. So, I mean, really mm-hmm. cold. It gets really hot. So.
Yeah.
But yeah, and it perfectly matches our jungle theme that we want to do in the room.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it's still very neutral, gender neutral.
We don't know, okay?
Yeah, I know.
We don't know.
We don't know what it is.
Well, this is really cool, and this is really nice.
Thank you very much,
thank
you guys.
Very much, Nicole and Rick. We really appreciate it. Yeah, thank mm-hmm. you. Thank you very much. You guys have been good friends, and this was totally definitely. Unexpected that you guys would send us something.
Yep.
So, I think that's about it. We have a couple more packages that we got to open up. We're waiting on... I know that my mom sent uh-huh, some stuff. We're waiting for the other half of that to show up. We have all the stuff. We have most of the stuff to put together the baby's room. So we'll probably do like a talk about all that stuff and show what Melissa's mom paid for.
And we also received very generously some hand-me-downs from one of my cousins that my dad and my stepmom have been sending to us.
Mm-hmm.
So we will definitely, some very nice stuff that we're going to
bring. Yeah, and that stuff has come in partially. So we'll probably wait
and
do like a walkthrough on all that stuff that came in too. So it's been amazing, all the people that have sent us stuff.
Yes, we are truly grateful for everybody who sent something and everybody who's like been interested in anything that's been going on with the baby.
Mm-hmm.
We just, mm-hmm. you know, it's nice.
Yeah, it's been really surprising. We thought that we would ask for people and create the the registry and hope that maybe we can get a few things here and there. And we're starting to creep up on, we're going to have everything from our registry.
Yeah, exactly. Almost everything, yeah.
Yeah, it's amazing, and I can't believe that this many people will send us stuff. So thanks again to everyone. Thank you, Rick and Nicole, for sending us this stuff.
Thank
it's really
you.
Nice. And we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.